Hey guys, my name is Freedom. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to import the Vroid Studio cartoon manga avatar into iClone 8 with the complete facial expressions, with the viseme, lip sync, and facial expression morph. Just have a look.
Viseme test. 1, 2, 3. Testing complete in iClone 8.
Just look at the facial expressions. Everything can work normal. Can work normal with the happy, surprise facial expression of the facial morph already done. And I'm going to show you all this step by step. The pipeline tutorial from Vroid Studio into iClone 8 and CC4, the character creator 4, as a non-standard human. How to set up all of the facial morph, import from the FBX, etc. And let's go. Hey guys, my name is Freedom. Today I'm going to show you how to import the Vroid Studio 3D avatar into CC4 and iClone 8, the character creator 4 and iClone 8 with the full facial expressions with the viseme. So start from now, I'm going to show you all the step by step. First, I'm going to just open the Vroid Studio. This is the latest version, the version 2.1.5. And I'm going to just choose a random 3D avatar from here. And as demo, I'm going to just choose her. And wait for a while, now it is loading. Right, now you can see it already loaded into here. So you can just design your Vroid avatar, the cartoon faces, and also all of the hairstyle, the body, the outfit, etc. And if you feel satisfied already, then just click here to export. Export as VRM as the first step. Right. Once you click it, you need to just wait for a few seconds until you can see here. Just need to click export, then scroll down, click export, then wait for a few seconds here. And as demo, I'm going to just export it on my desktop. Just right click to create a new folder, name this as model 01. The avatar sample, I'm going to just name this VRM as model 01. Now, once you finish this, then go into the folder. You can see it is a VRM file. Next, we are going to convert this VRM file to become FBX file. You need to just go to my video description to get the Vroid to FBX converter, the Vroid VRM to FBX converter. Just double click. If you already get it, then open the Blender 2.9 that you can see in the folder. Then just open the Blender at here. This is something that I already installed all the plugin and already proved that this can work. So next step, just go to the Edit Preferences, Add-on, Install from the desktop, the Vroid to FBX converter. Inside there are two zip folders. The two zip folders are at here. The two chip folder inside the Vroid to FBX converter. You need to install both plugin. So I'm going to just install the cat first, then just install again the VRM add-on. Then search for cat. Make sure you activate it by ticket. Then search for VRM. Make sure the VRM import already activated as well. Then close. Close. Then in Blender here, click the empty area, press A to select all, and press delete to delete everything. Then press N until you can see the VRM and cats. Click the cats, click the triple line here. Just import the VRM from the location that you exported just now, the model 01 VRM. Double click it. Then add here. Go to the wrench setting. Untick everything here and only select the fixed material and then remove the zero weight bones. These two are very important. Click OK, then click fix model and wait for a few seconds until it's done, until you can see all of the textures. At this moment, you can just save as the FBX file. Just click file, export FBX, then on the desktop, Model 01, the path mode choose copy, and here make sure you highlight it. This setting is to make sure all of the material texture embedded inside the FBX file. Name the FBX file as model 01 as well. Just click export the FBX. It is going to export at here, then you can import into the CC4 first. Now, the blend file, I also save it together at the same place in case if I want to edit it later. So I just name this blend file as model 01, save. I have the blender file as well. Now I close this. Next, just open the character creator for the CC4. And we are going to use this CC4 to import the FBX file and make it become a CC avatar, make it become an iAvatar, a non-standard human avatar inside the CC4 first. This is the first step that's before you go into the iClone. Alright, next step, just drag in the FBX file into the CC4, import as the character, click apply. And wait for a few seconds here. And next we are going to just map all of the bones here. Just double click it from here. Make sure you plot all the bones correctly. Just one by one. You can plot the finger as well, but as demo, I'm going to just ignore the fingers and just plot the main bones that's required to convert it to become a non-standard human avatar. Right, once done this step, just click active and just click the characterization to quit from here. Next, we are going to fix all of the material texture here. Click the material. And from here, we are going to generate the opacity map for every of the material. So now here, I just right click copy and right click paste here. It is going to generate the opacity map. Copy, paste, wait. Right click copy, right click paste. One by one, you should fix it one by one, but it just within 1 minute, you can finish it. Just fix all materials here. It will automatically generate the opacity map for every time you copy the paste. You copy and paste the same base color map at here. You can just observe the face, it become more and more get fixed. It just left some of it. It is going to fix all of the transparency. You convert it. The more material texture you have, the more you need to do and repeat this step. The face already become okay, then just left a few clothing. Done. You can see done already, all of the material texture already get fixed. So next, we are going to import all of the facial expression morph at here. But before that, just click the first material and scroll down until you can see the last material. Hold the shift button and click the last one. Get all selected and the self illumination, just make it maximum because this is a cartoon, this is a manga. We want to see all of the 2D effects. Make sure everything looks beautiful. And next, go to the facial expression editor, just click here, facial profile editor, click one more time, it should show it here. Then click here, click the edit the expression, then click here the FBX file. Go and select the FBX file that you import just now, the model 01 FBX, double click. It is going to import all of the facial expression morph. Then here, just name morph at here. Click OK. Now just check the morph. You can see all of the facial expression morph already done correctly. Everything look nice. See, surprise. All right, next we are going to just set the viseme, the talking animation, and the eye blinking. First, just scroll down until you can see the eyes close, the right. Then go to the eye blink, the right hand side, click the quick update, then done. Then go to the morph again, check the close eyes left, then go to the eye blink, click the quick update, done. Next is the mouth opens. Go to the morph until you can see right, just see the O, AIOU at here, just look at the O, just make the mouth open. Then just go to the viseme, click here to have a quick update, then close it. Once you've done these three steps, you already set up the facial expression. So now we can just save this CC project file at here, click file, save as. At the model 01, just name this as model 01, save as a CC project file, and at the same time you export as iAvatar, export at the same folder as well, model 01.iAvatar save. Alright, now you already done, you already converted the Vroid avatar to become a non-standard human avatar in CC4, and we are going to test it in iClone 8. Now I'm going to just open the iClone 8, the iClone 8.53. This is the latest version for today. We are going to test inside the iClone to check the facial expression, to check the viseme. All of this is that it is already ready to create the animation. Just wait for a while waiting the iClone 8 to finish load it. Right, done. The iClone 8 ready, loaded. Next, we want to test it. We just need to just drag in the iAvatar. The iAvatar. Drag and drop into the iClone 8. And we are going to test the viseme and the animation. So first, I'm going to just test the viseme first. Right, so now I just make sure I select it, then modify at here, this one, until you can see create a script. We test the viseme, create script, then it is going to appear this as demo. I'm going to just choose the TTS. You can record your own voice or you can use the audio file like MP4 or WAV as well. I'm going to test by using the TTS. I'm going to just test this viseme test 1, 2, 3 testing complete in iClone 8. The voice mode, I'm going to just choose the female Microsoft Jira, the pitch 100, and I hear it.
Viseme test 1, 2, 3 testing complete in iClone 8.
So now I click OK, it is going to apply as the viseme, and I'm going to have to check it to see is that it works by opening the mouth. Try.
Viseme test 1, 2, 3 testing complete in iClone 8.
See? The viseme already done set up.
Viseme test 1, 2, 3 testing complete in iClone 8.
So next I'm going to test the facial expression. To test the facial expression, I'm going to the face key. click OK. Then you can see the face key. Then click the modified until you can see the morph. So now, let's say if I want to test the surprise. Alright, so I'm going to just test the surprise after a few seconds.
Viseme test. 1, 2, 3. Testing completed. In iClone 8.
Then at this moment, I'm going to just make her surprise. After a few seconds, this surprise. After 1 second, the surprise back to the zero. So now I'm going to just check. At this moment. So I try.
Viseme test. 1, 2, 3. Testing complete in iClone 8.
The facial expression is okay. This is just one of the morph. And you can test others as well. Let's say here is fun. After a few seconds, the fun maximum. So now I try to play the whole animation.
Viseme test. 1, 2, 3. Testing complete in iClone 8.
This is surprise. And back to normal. Then here you can see this is joy, this is fun. Alright, now I'm going to test the body animation as well. I'm going to just try some animation at here. Motion, human, female, Edo. I try this.
Viseme test. 1, 2, 3.
Alright, I test this. Better.
Viseme test. 1, 2, 3. Testing complete in iClone 8.
See, everything worked normal. Done. Alright, that's all for today about my tutorials on how to just import any of the Vroid Studio cartoon and manga avatar into the CC4 and iClone 8, the Character Creator 4 and iClone 8 to make it become a non-standard human avatar, included all of the viseme, lip sync, and also the facial expression morph. And that's all for today. Thank you for watching. If you love my videos, tutorials, and sharings, if you feel all these tutorials and sharings are very helpful to your 3D modeling, 3D animations, and 3D game developing, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel and also turn on the mini bell and select all so that when next time I publish a new videos, tutorials, or sharings, you receive a notification immediately. See you in my next video. Enjoy. Happy 3D modeling, 3D animations, and 3D game developing. See you.